Hey, welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to be taking a look at MPC's 125th scale kit of Don Garlett's rear engines dragster, or known as Swamp Rat 14, when he switched to a rear engine platform and kind of changed up the game. Inside the box, we're going to have a display piece to display the completed model kit, full decal sheet, styrene parts, chrome parts, and MPC's sweet vinyl pad printed tires. Let's take a look inside the box. They also include this neat little pamphlet, this nice little leaflet inside that actually explains the story behind the rear engine dragster. And for the factoid folks that love all that information, a full spec and chassis list of the vehicle to give you all the information you ever need to know about that rear engine dragster, the Swamp Rat 14. The manual is a nice retro style manual. Fold out steps A through N. There is actually something in the manual I wanted to show you. It's a really cool tip. Right here, when you start assembling that super skinny, long nose dragster body, they say to tape it from the inside, then apply your decals, then slice on those body seams to get those decals to have two parts without having to worry about how to line them up. So that's a pretty cool tip. Goes A through N, and you've got your full assembly done. Shouldn't take longer than a day for full assembly. Also included in the box, something Round 2 does that I just love, they make these sweet full-color display bases. So you've got your fence here. You've even got the tower for the drag racers. You got our little flag man here. Check him out. He's kind of cute. Look at that little guy. And then you've got your base. Announces the car, Swamp Rat 14, MPC Round 2 kit. Once you fold all that up, you put the base on like that. It stands up, you can display your model. That really adds to a lot of candy for the eyes on the shelf. And I absolutely love that. I think it's so cool that they put that stuff in the kits nowadays. We've got a sweet decal sheet. They've really got their decal on point here. You can see we've got white lettering, we've got full sponsor decals, real names, not fake names, actual sponsor decals. So it's gonna be authentic, it's gonna look great. We've got some white decals in there, so just look as I go through real slow to catch that light on the white decal. They all look great. And anything that you have left over, save it for your other Legends of the Quarter Mile Dragsters. Up next will be some small stuff here, but of course, always important, Round 2 MPC sweet pad-printed vinyl tires. Look at those big Goodyear slicks. Give those a little scuff with some sandpaper. Those are going to look absolutely awesome. Nice and flexible. They look the part. They look real. Inside this box here, we didn't want to open this up. I don't want to lose these little small parts before I build, but that's your little windscreen and a metal axle. That's all that's in that bag. Now we're going to move on to styrene. First up, a huge chrome tree. That is a lot of chrome. We've got the spoiler on there, wheels, lines, linkages, hoses. We've got our coils, front wheels, valve covers, blower housing, oil pan, blower drive, fuel can, linkages, steering, and blower cover, and much more. Those deep dish wheels in the back there. Just all kinds of good looking chrome on that tree there. And it's all nice and smooth. We've got this cool black plastic coming up here. I'm going to show you some of the major components, then we'll move on to the smaller trees. Before we close out the review, you have a deployed parachute if you wish to use it. All molded and stiff styrene so it won't collapse on you if you want to have it sitting behind the car like he's still in motion. That looks pretty awesome. They do include that. The chassis is just, it's a work of molded art. I mean, for one, it's perfectly straight. If you ever had to assemble one of these chassis and you're not that experienced with a plastic assembly, it can be kind of difficult. This thing is ramrod straight. I mean, look at that. It's not wobbling. It's not falling down. And it's all done for you and it's all molded in one piece. So it can't, you know, you can't, don't have to worry about gluing these little cross members in and gluing the two chassis sides together. The whole frame is done for you and it's all ready to go. And you know that it's straight out of the box, which means all four tires will touch the ground when you're done. We've got the body panels here. Molded in black, all nice and smooth. That'll accept paint real easy, but you don't have to paint it. It's already molded in black. If you just like to build and put the decals on, stick it on the shelf. These nice pre-done in black body panels will help you get that whole kit done. Not a lot of parts in this kit, because obviously these are pretty simplistic vehicles. They're just made to do one thing, go really fast in a straight line. We've got some parts that fell off the tree. It's not a big deal, but I'll make sure I show them to you. We've got some roll cage chassis parts. Nice thin moldings. I haven't seen any flash worth worrying about. We've got our block half. For that 426, we've got our driver's seat with the belts molded in. That's awesome. And then on this one here, we've got the cylinder heads. We've got our packed chute. If you want to show it with a packed chute, we've got our blower belt and various other small bits and bobs, including the other half of the block and the cylinder heads for that 426 listed in the spec sheet. And then finally, we've got our driver loop, the driver's roll cage loops right there. We've got our headers. We've got our front tires. They do have Goodyear molded into them. I'm not sure I can get it to focus in close enough, but you should be able to see it around the bottom there. And you'll just cut out that little disc there so they could mold those nice skinny front tires. And then we've got our differential there. Or spool, actually. Rear end is what we'll call it. We'll just say rear end because it's not really a differential, but that's that. So that's all the parts that are in that kit. It doesn't have a huge amount of parts. It has a lot of cool stuff in it. That's going to be everything you're going to get when you go pick up yours, and you know you're going to want it now. Don Garlett's Rear Engine Dragster Swamp Rat 14 from MPC. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.